Shalom, family. Shalom. So I get information that Tyson Foods. Now I don't know if you're familiar with the big corporation Tyson, Tyson Chicken, but they also dabble in a lot of other meats and food items. They have a lot of sister companies. They have a lot of contracts with different corporations all around the United States of America and even other parts of around the world. Tyson Foods is firing 1,200 of its workers, American blue-collar workers. And they're going to replace them with illegal immigrants. And Tyson say they are going to provide financial assistance for the legal paperwork and illegal situations with becoming with the immigration process. I don't know if you ever worked at Tyson Foods before, but right here where I live in Shelbyville, Tennessee, there is a complex, there's a factory, there's a slaughterhouse. They employ thousands of workers. A lot of them are illegal immigrants from countries such as Afghanistan, Jordan, Pakistan. Countries from the Middle East. A lot of these migrants and immigrants already work there. It's a culture shock whenever you work in a place like that where there's a lot of different languages that are spoken. It's a very mixed bag of different cultures and different people from all around planet Earth work there. There's so many different languages. But there is a strong lack of communication in a place. Tyson Foods say we're going to hire them illegal immigrants. We're going to go ahead and fire those American workers, those American blue-collar workers. They can be replaced. Now, family, I'm here to tell you the boycott of Tyson Foods and its sister companies and the companies that it, corporations that it provides chicken and product, food products to around the earth, particularly here in America. Now the American public, some of you might not be aware of what Tyson is up to just yet. Big corporation Tyson, Tyson Foods. But what's really getting ready to unfold here is a total boycott for Tyson Foods here in America. Shalom, family. Shalom.